raise them if you got them. You don't have to have a glass, and if you do have a glass, you do not have to have alcohol in it. But cheers to you guys. Thank you for making this possible. Welcome, everyone. Thank you for tuning in. My name is Nico. I go by CointRick and CointrickTwitch online. And today, I'm going to be showing you all how to make a sour build. A sour build is sort of a whole school of cocktails that encompasses things like daiquiris, gimlets with both gin or vodka, and whiskey sours. The reason I want to show you guys how to build a bar around a specific kind of drink, or even one specific drink. Most people ask me what bottles they should have. What tequila, what rum, what whiskey, what vodka, what gin, or whatever. It's a valid question. But if you're gonna do this at home, you should expect that most of the drinks that you make will be for yourself. Getting one of everything so that you can make something for everybody and anybody who ever comes through your door is ill-advised. You're gonna end up wasting a lot of money, you're gonna have bottles on your back bar that almost never get used, but I'm gonna show you or talk you through a few different drinks and what bottles you need behind your bar, what kind of produce and other ingredients you need behind your bar, how to iterate on those drinks, and then how to move forward and branch out from those into other things. There are about five different kinds of builds, meaning there are five, we'll say, archetypical, like, base, empirical classic cocktails. In a very broad sense, you have the old-fashioned as one school, and then you have Manhattans as a separate school of cocktails, daiquiris as a separate school of cocktails, sidecars as a separate school of cocktails, and then, like, flips, kind of, technically? Like creamy, foamy sort of cocktails as the last one. A sour build is going to be two parts your base liquor, one part your citrus, and then one part your sweetener. Some bartenders, depending on where you are and how they've been trained, basically what kinds of words they use, some bartenders will say two parts liquor, one part sour, one part sweet. It's the same thing. It's almost exactly the same thing. When we talk about the daiquiri, which I mentioned earlier, is white rum, lime juice, and simple syrup. If you apply that build, that sort of archetype, that outline, that means that it's gonna be two parts your white rum, and then one part your simple syrup, and then one part your lime juice. And that builds your daiquiri. Same thing is true of gimlets and whether you make them with vodka or gin. So the quick footnote about whiskey sours. Most bartenders understand, or they know implicitly, that whiskey sours are made two different ways. The most traditional classic whiskey sour is gonna be whiskey, probably bourbon if you live in the US, two parts of that whiskey, one part simple syrup, and then one part lemon juice. Jean-Luc's here, yay. Cheers.
Cheers. Raise them if you got them.
Raise them if you got them.
For the last week, my body has been a temple. That temple is now being raided and pillaged.
That's what a sour build is. The one main exception that I mentioned earlier, that I made that footnote about, is the whiskey sour, which is whiskey, lemon juice, simple syrup, or whatever, granulated sugar, some kind of sweetener. And it's served in some bars that way when you order it that way. Traditionally, classically, all the way back, there is also egg white in that cocktail to create this foamy, fluffy, pillowy sort of texture to the drink so that all of your really aromatic, intense flavors become kind of supple and creamy, and they play better together. A good bartender will ask you whether you want an egg white or not. So we're gonna try, and I'm gonna show you how to make a gimlet and how to make a daiquiri, what bottles you want behind your bar if you're doing sour builds, what kind of produce, herbs, spices, bitters, or whatever you might need behind your bar if you're doing sour builds, and where to go from there. By the way, don't, for the love of God, don't try and start a 12 bottle bar. If you do that, you're gonna end up with bottles that you hate, or bottles that you never use, or bottles that you replace and then forget about. I'm gonna give you one bottle to start with, and then when you master that, or when you're comfortable with that flavor profile at home, I'm gonna give you some recommendations for other bottles that you can go out and pick up. Having a collection at home, even if it's not like that, even if it's like the size of just one of these shelves, even if it's the size of, like, literally just one shelf, it's still a really impressive feature to have at home. We're gonna start with, I think, the most accessible, the most known is gonna be the daiquiri. Oof. So you're gonna wanna start with a silver rum, lime, simple syrup, or granulated sugar. We're going to start with three things. For a silver rum, I really recommend Bacardi Superior. This is incredibly consistent. You remember all of those pieces of equipment that I mentioned in that previous live stream, that previous video that I did, that you guys are going to need at home? This is a shaken cocktail. You'll know if a cocktail is shaken or stirred, by the way, if the ingredients have different densities or different natures. An old fashioned, the ingredients aren't all of the same nature, but the densities are relatively the same. When you're working with sugar and alcohol, which is a kind of sugar, and bitters, which are typically derived from alcohol, all of those things will typically naturally want to commingle together, so they don't need to be shaken to be emulsified to a common density. Other drinks that are a little bit simpler, like a Manhattan or a martini, a dry martini with dry vermouth, those will be typically stirred or should be typically stirred because all of those ingredients will be derived from alcohol. Now, the reason that you shake this is because it has citrus. This lime juice. The lime juice is a different density and it's a different nature from the alcohol and the sugar that we have here in the simple syrup and the rum. So it needs to be shaken to emulsify those ingredients together, forcing them to become homogeneous. It also does dilute them, it also does chill them down. So take your measuring utensil. The reason I'm starting by juicing the limes, even though it would be easier to measure the liquor or the simple syrup because they're both liquid ingredients, I'm starting with the limes because looking at a solid whole lime, the amount of juice that I get from this is actually going to be inconsistent. Once I know how much lime juice I can get out of this one lime, that will tell me how much simple syrup and how much white rum I need in the cocktail in general. Typically, bartenders won't be trained to measure ingredients this way. Bartenders will be trained to start with their liquor and then work their way down. Working from your cheapest ingredient or your scarcest ingredient up is relatively rare, but if you're doing it at home, I think it's a good way to start. That way you don't end up screwing up your drink or committing to a drink that is inherently flawed. What we actually have here is about 3/4 ounce of lime juice, which means I need 1.5 ounces of white rum. Measure that out there. Show you guys what that looks like here. Right there, there's a line there in my measuring device, and we're just gonna... Kasutin! Good morning, Nico. I want to start drinking, but I have work in 2 hours. I mean, I'm not gonna be the guy to convince you to start drinking. I mean, if you have work and you don't want to drink... Sorry for hitting my microphone. If you don't want to drink, you feel uncomfortable drinking, then radical idea, don't drink. You don't have to. That's a basic daiquiri. So the main difference between this and another classic cocktail that you guys are probably hopefully familiar with is that a mojito is very nearly the same thing. On paper, it is the same thing with the addition of mint. A mojito typically involves muddling, which is a whole other intricate process that I could do an entire live stream about. But in large part, if you master the daiquiri this way, using simple syrup, fresh lime juice, and a white rum, you are literally one step away from making a pretty kick-ass mojito at home. And to do that, you really only need mint. You don't even need to muddle the mint if you know what you're doing. Cheers. It's another reason I didn't want to take a shot is because I was already working on a cocktail. So that's the difference between this and a mojito. And this is a sour build. I mentioned earlier, I did 1 part citrus, 1 part sweetener, 2 parts alcohol. The common variation on this is going to be your gimlet, which is a little bit more probably classic than a daiquiri. Gimlets come in 2 main varieties. Gimlets are either made with gin or they're made with vodka, but the rest of the ingredients are relatively the same. So I'll show you guys how to make 1 gimlet. I'm going to be making it with gin to illustrate a point. Roku Japanese gin. Another lime. and simple syrup. All right, this time, let me grab my ice ahead of time. Same deal, start with your lime if you're doing it fresh. That way you know how much citrus juice you're working with. This is a little bit less lime juice than the last lime that I had. This is somewhere between 1/2 and 3/4 ounces. So this will probably be a little bit less. So we're gonna do 1/2 ounce of that and 1/2 ounce of this simple syrup. About 1 ounce of the gin that we're using. Combine those ingredients together, and then left-handed shake. Crack it open. And then, same deal. It's the same ratio as the daiquiri that we made just a second ago. It's just that this is made with gin instead of white rum. So the reason I chose gin instead of making this with vodka, which will traditionally be the same cocktail, is that this is your daiquiri, this is your gimlet. I mentioned that if you add mint in some form to your daiquiri, it essentially becomes a mojito, or at least it becomes a mojito in spirit. Anything being anything else in spirit is kind of the whole point. So, if you add mint to your gin gimlet or your French gimlet, depending on how you label this thing, you have a whole other cocktail. You don't have a mojito and you don't have a gimlet. What you have is a south side. You could build a whole bar at home. You could get a white rum, you could get a vodka, you could get gin, get limes, get simple syrup or granulated sugar. That's only 5 things. And you get a little pack of mint and you can already make 6 different cocktails. That's the whole thing. You can get six items from the grocery store, in the liquor store, the gas station, or depending on where you live, and you can make 6 cocktails at home, which will entertain a whole slew of people if you're really interested in making shaken, refreshing, citrus-forward cocktails. I recommend that you get a white rum, vodka, and or gin. You only need one of those depending on your own personal preference. And then also get lime juice, simple syrup, and mint. If you want to take this a step further, you can also get agave syrup and tequila, and you can start making margaritas. You can get Cointreau and start making margaritas, but that's all up to you. I want to keep this as simple as possible. Thank you guys for tuning in. I appreciate it. If you want to catch me live, I'm live on Twitch Monday through Thursday, 5 p.m. to 9 p.m. EST. I'm also live Sundays at 7 p.m. EST playing D&D from here at the bar. So I hope to see you guys there.